السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and bless every one of us and grant us every form of goodness. Ameen. My beloved brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek something known as husnul khatima, which means a good ending. This good ending was referring to being within the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the highest degree when death overtakes a person. So it's important for us to look into what is husnul khatima and how we can achieve it. So firstly, if we were to look at what is husnul khatima, al-khatima means the end, the finishing. And it does not depict the total end of yourselves and myself or anyone else, but rather the soul moving from one stage to another. The stage we are in right now, where the soul is in these temporary bodies, is known as the life of this world, al-hayatul dunya, the life within this world. Thereafter, the soul will be separated from these temporary bodies and it will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what is known as al-barzakh. Al-barzakh is a place where the souls are kept in waiting for the day of judgment. So the waiting period between now and the day of judgment, for those who've passed away, those souls would actually be in a place known as al-barzakh. We have been told very little about it and we would never be able to elaborate more than what we've been told, because it is a matter of the unseen. Remember, my brothers and sisters, anything that has to do with matters of the unseen, you and I cannot guess them. We cannot come up with any form of suggestions and details unless it was through revelation that was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he gave us those details. So no one can see a dream and claim that Allah came to him or her today and inform them about details of the barzakh, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was the most knowledgeable of all of us, has not given us that detail. We need to understand this. So the soul right now is on earth. We feel like this life is full, but it is actually a deception. وَمَا هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهْوٌ وَلَعِبٌ وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانُ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Indeed, the life of this world is just but amusement and play. The real life is that of the hereafter, if only but they knew and they recognized. Subhanallah. So when we are coming to an end of our time that Allah has prescribed on this earth, we need to understand a few things. Number one, when you were born, already your date of death was written. So no matter what, you will die at a time that Allah has fixed for you, even prior to your date of birth. Subhanallah. So Allah fixed a time. Nothing's going to change that. إِنَّ أَجَلَ اللَّهِ إِذَا جَاءَ لَا يُؤَخَّرُ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. When the prescribed time comes, it will never ever be delayed. That time fixed by Allah, if you know and you understand, you will know it will never be delayed, neither by a moment this way or be brought forward by a moment that way. Allah says, إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ فَلَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. If their time, or when their prescribed time comes, they will not be delayed even by a moment, nor will it be brought forward even by a moment. That's something you need to know. Secondly,
It does not mean that because Allah has predestined and determined your date of death that you need to become careless. It does not mean that you need to tell yourself, well, what's the point of any form of precaution for anything? It's like when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked about the camel, I trust in Allah, should I tie my camel or should I leave it? Because my trust is very strong. He says, tie your camel and then trust in Allah. So Allah is testing us on this earth. One of the things He wants us to do is preserve and protect life and preserve and protect the amana known as this body that He has given you. So you will protect the body to the best of the capacity and capability and understanding that Allah has given you. Some people will have a different understanding. Yes, no problem. You know, sometimes you might think if I drive at 60 kilometers an hour, it is dangerous. And someone else might think if I drive at 100 kilometers an hour, it is still safe. Obviously, it's a different understanding. The experts will tell you on this road, you're not supposed to go beyond 120. You might come up and say, well, I have a vehicle that was now made in 2021. We're sitting here almost February 2021. Someone might say, I have a vehicle that way outdates, or should I say, is so much advanced compared to the time when they determined what a safe speed is on these roads. You know, people will come up with all sorts of things. So it's an argument, and I agree, it is an argument. Still, stick to the limits, subhanallah. Perhaps a little bit this way, that way. But remember, you need to do what you believe is very, very safe. Because if you were beyond that, perhaps, who knows, it might be in the eyes of Allah considered suicide because you abandoned all forms of precaution in terms of safety, road safety rules, and you were very, very negligent. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. So that is the end of this life. Like I said, one, the determined time. Two, because of the time being determined, it does not mean that you become complacent. Allah will hold you responsible. It's like a person committing suicide and saying, I'm going to hang myself. If Allah has written my death, I will die. If He hasn't, I won't. There are people who make similar statements with different wording, perhaps a different type of suicide. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. He has given us that understanding, and we need to have a deep understanding of what He requires and wants from us while we're on earth. My brothers, my sisters, you and I know that at this point in our lives, there has never been such a time as the time we are going through right now, where at any given moment, you can hear of a healthy person just passing away within a few days of falling ill or moments. And this is a prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There will be something known as al-maut al-fujai, death that is going to come towards the end of times, where it will be so sudden. You see a person today and tomorrow you don't see him. That is a sign of the end of times. And obviously, although qiyamah might be distant in terms of years, it is very, very near. Innahum yarawnahu ba'idan wa narahu qareeba. Allah speaks of it when He says, they see it very far and we see it very near. Remember, time is a creature of Allah. So for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must understand that this time is nothing. Getting back to what we were saying, so I need to prepare for the day I'm going to go back to Allah. The day that the whole objective of myself being on earth comes to an end. And what was that? Allah says, well, I sent you on earth in order to test you, in order that you will go through challenges and difficulty, hardship upon hardship, and I will tell you what to do, what not to do. You must pass all those tests one after the other. I will reward you for every test you passed, whether it is a sickness, an illness, a failure, loss, whether it is loss of produce, loss of people, you know, death of loved ones, your own injury, your health being taken away, your jobs being lost, perhaps so many other things, uncertainty, insecurity. All of that Allah mentions in the Quran. And Allah says, we will test you with all of that. That's part of the reason why we created you, in order for you to go through those challenges one by one. And then you return to Allah, having told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I tried my best, I did my best. You sent me challenges upon challenge, challenge upon challenge, and I passed these challenges. Subhanallah. May Allah grant us the ability to be strong, steadfast. Sabr is something that is amazing. Two things, sabr and shukr. You know, the affairs of a true believer are absolutely amazing. When something good happens, he is thankful to Allah. It makes him closer to Allah. It's better for him. When something bad happens to him, according to his own understanding, then he is patient and it is good for him. He earns a reward from that too. So we are in a win-win situation. We earn a reward when good happens because it makes us closer to Allah. That's why we say, when goodness comes in your direction, don't ever be from among those who turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and when some calamity strikes, we bear patience and we thank Allah. It draws us closer to Allah. So that was also good for us. Now, with all these tests, they will come to an end one day when you pass away. And that is al-khatima, the end, your end. Your end for what? The end of the period of time wherein the soul was in this temporary body. Such a temporary body, subhanallah. If I were to chop my own finger off, I won't feel what's happening to that finger when it's separated from my body, because the soul is with the rest of the body and no longer with that particular finger. Subhanallah. That's the plan of Allah. How it works, Allah alone knows. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. So my brothers and sisters, in order to have the best ending of your exam, you know, it reminds me of a marathon where you start off and you run steady. The best of runners, the best of these long distance runners, they are steady throughout the 3,000 meters perhaps, and they're going round the track. When it comes to the last lap or last two laps, they pick up the pace. They want to end on a very high note. And many times the race is won in the last few hundred meters, when you find the real runner overtaking all the others, and then they end with that ribbon being cut and the ribbon moving from its place, and they are so happy and excited. We need to lead our lives similar to that marathon. Keep going, even if it's a slow pace. Keep going. Khayrul amali ma dima alayhi wa in qal. The best of deeds, those which are done regularly, even if they are less. Do them regularly. Keep a steady pace. Read Quran every day, one page. It's better than reading one juz a day and then leaving it for a whole month. Fulfill your salah every single day. Do some sunnah. Do some adhkar. Write down what you want to do, what you have to do on a daily basis. Because I promise you, my brothers, my sisters, a day will come when you will go and I will go. On that day, I want Allah to be pleased with me. So if I want husnul khatima, I need to do regular deeds. I need to make sure that my compulsory deeds, I do them. And don't fall prey for those who are trying to contaminate the mind by finding fault in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, trying to find fault actually, and trying to find fault in the Quran and in revelation and this and that. And sometimes hadith, some of the ahadith are fabricated, some of them are authentic. And sometimes people come to us with a mixture and try to confuse us. They want to make us lose our faith when we don't realize at times, due to weakness, that ultimately we're going to go back to He who made us. And all that Islam teaches us is to worship the one who made you and none other than that. So if you want husnul khatima, you make sure you never worship anyone besides Allah. Man mata la yushriku billahi shay'an dakhala al-jannah. Whoever passes away without having associated partners with Allah, or they sought forgiveness for the association of partnership with Allah, and after that they never ever associated partnership with Allah, they will enter Jannah, they will enter paradise. Allah says the whole aim is to worship Allah alone. And then you need to understand, every act of worship, number one, it's rendered only for Allah. Number two, it should be from that which was taught by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Many times we become very encouraged by that which was not done by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in terms of acts of worship, because people are doing it. And so we feel energized. People tell you, let's do this. And you know it's a bid'ah, it's an innovation. And people are energized towards innovation, but they are not energized towards that which is simple. But it was done by the Prophet ﷺ. It was taught by him. He did not miss it at times, and so on. Do you know why? Shaitan encourages you to do that and does not encourage you to do this. You see the difference? Subhanallah. People say, why is it that we are so energized when it comes to adultery and haram, and we are so, you know, for example, we feel so lazy when it comes to halal? It's because shaitan is beautifying one thing and he's not beautifying the other. In fact, he's trying to make it ugly. So the same applies to sunnah and bid'ah, that which is taught by the Prophet ﷺ in terms of acts of worship, and that which is not taught. What is taught, we feel lazy to do it. We feel, you know what, it's something that's so simple, so easy. I need to do something more complicated. Wallahi, complicated or not, the sunnah is what you should be doing, and not that which is innovation, no matter how satisfying it might make you feel, because it is a false sense of satisfaction. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So, while we worship Allah alone in preparation for Husnul Khatima, to prepare for Husnul Khatima, you need to make sure you're following the sunnah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will recognize us in the hereafter based on how much we followed him, and based on how much we adopted what he taught. We want to be part of his ummah and his nation. We want to achieve the intercession that he will have on that particular day. But there will come a time when, or there is a place upon the hawd meaning the pond, a special pond with water that never depletes. And if anyone drinks from it, they will never feel thirsty again, known as hawd al-kawthar. Al-kawthar is that pond. The Prophet ﷺ says, I will be waiting for you lot on that hawd. And you know what? I will recognize you from the places that you washed 5 times a day when making wudu. Sometimes it's less than 5 because you may hold your wudu for more than one prayer. But that which you washed for wudu, then there will be people who will be taken away from me. And I will say, oh Allah, this is from me, from my ummah. And he will say, you don't know what they did after you. They turned away from your teachings and your sunnah, etc., etc. These were the champions of bid'ah, the champions of that which was innovation. And they enjoyed it, they loved it, they taught it, they preached it and promoted it. Let's not be from among those. No matter how simple the sunnah is, and the sunnah will always be easy and simple, be quenched by it, be satisfied by it in a way that it does not lead you to what shaitan wants you to go into, and that is the innovation. My beloved brothers and sisters, prepare for the day you're going to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing what? By ensuring you have not wronged a fellow human being. So if you want husnul khatima, develop your character, your conduct, speak to people well, be charitable, help people a lot. When you give out lots of charity, there will be lots of barakah in your life, blessings in your life, even though your life may be short because it might have been destined that you might die at an early age. But the beauty is when Allah is pleased with you, no matter what the figure of your age was. So if you died at 30, 50, 60 or 100, for as long as Allah is pleased with you, that was a good death, beautiful death. Husnul Khatima. Husnul Khatima is when Allah is pleased with you at the point of your death. That is known as Husnul Khatima. At times, you might die in a car crash, but Allah is pleased with you. Subhanallah. But if you are dying while committing a sin, then that is known as su'ul khatima. It's the opposite of husnul khatima. It is a bad ending. Imagine while you're committing a sin, you're dying. May Allah protect us. The Prophet ﷺ used to say, Allahumma ja'al khayra ayyamina awakhiraha wa khayra a'malina khawatimaha. Oh Allah, make the best of our days on earth the last days, and make the best of our deeds here on earth the last of our deeds, and the best of our days from all the days, may it be the day that we meet you, O Allah, the day that we see you. Subhanallah. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So my brothers and sisters, we've touched a little bit about Husnul Khatima, or on Husnul Khatima, the issue of predestiny, a good death, the fact that if you die in the obedience of Allah, while Allah is pleased with you, alhamdulillah, it's a good death. If you die while seeking forgiveness, and you had sought the forgiveness and you changed your life, it's a good death. These are reminders from Allah. Imagine people around us are dying and we still don't take heed. أَوَلَا يَرَوْنَ أَنَّهُمْ يُفْتَنُونَ فِي كُلِّ عَامٍ مَرَّةً أَوْ مَرَّتَيْنَ ثُمَّ لَا يَتُوبُونَ وَلَا هُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. Do they not see that we test them once or twice every year? They are tested with major tests. And these tests include everything, whether it's war, whether it's death, whether it's other challenges or sickness or whatever else it may be. Allah says we test them once or twice every year and they are still not repenting to Allah. They are still not turning away, meaning from shaitan, and coming towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, why not? In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. Subhanallah. Do they not see that we come to the earth and we are minimizing it from around them? We are making it smaller and smaller. Subhanallah. There are many meanings of that. But one of it is a reminder for us to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the lesson. When Allah is making things smaller and smaller. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness and ease. May Allah open our doors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and grant us husnul khatima. Another way of achieving husnul khatima, over and above developing your character, being charitable, don't wrong anyone at all. Don't wrong people. When you have been unjust, you cannot have a good death. When you have been a tyrant, you will not have a good death. Take a look at the tyrants around you. When you have usurped the wealth of people, when you have been an ugly individual to others, when you have served a cause of corruption and chaos and bribery and whatever else, you can never have a good death. Subhanallah. When you have stolen from people, when you have eaten the rights of others, you can never have a good death, even though you might die on your bed at home. Subhanallah. It's not a good death when Allah is displeased with you and when all of the people around you are happy that you've gone. That's not a good death. Subhanallah. Imagine, people are happy. I remember a time when we were talking about someone and some people were saying, well, this guy died. Oh, wow, good riddance. Imagine, what a statement. And someone said, he should have died 5 years ago, man. May Allah forgive us. Live your life in such a way that people around you appreciate your goodness, appreciate what you've done, the service for the deen, the service for the community, the ummah, the people. You promoted a just cause and you stood for something that was fair and balanced. Then you will be granted a good death. And finally and ultimately, my brothers and sisters, keep asking Allah for husnul khatima. Allahumma inni as'aluka husnul khatima. Oh Allah, I ask you a good ending. Oh Allah, I ask you for a good death. Allahumma barikli fil mawti wa fima ba'da al mawt. Oh Allah, grant me blessings in death, meaning give me a blessed death, and give me blessings even beyond death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to take heed. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad.